So today's topic of discussion is food preservation by natural antimicrobial compounds. We have already studied food preservation by different type of chemicals, by different kind of thermal methods, non-thermal methods, and how it is affecting the growth and activity of different kind of microorganisms generally found in your food items, and which are responsible for creating several type of abnormal condition in your final product. So today we will discuss about the natural antimicrobial compounds which are naturally available, or it is extract of different type of food items which people have started using for preservation purposes, as well as they are also using these compounds for giving a specific type of flavor, color, or different type of specific characteristic in their final product. So we have already studied about the preservation, and we have studied a number of different type of definitions given by different organizations or different scientists. So here, as per the FASAI, preservative means a substance which, when added to food, is capable of inhibiting, retarding, or arresting the process of fermentation, acidification, and other decomposition of food. So whatever material or whatever extract from plant source or animal source or some bacterial source, we are deliberately using it in some kind of food just to restrict the growth and activity of different kind of microbes which are responsible for creating excessive amount of acid, or sometimes it is responsible for creating abnormal type of fermentation in your final product, and ultimately it will create some kind of decomposition problem, and ultimately your food will become abnormal. So it is very important to know the different groups and how it is working and what are the mode of action of these different preservative which you are selecting for a specific type of purposes in your food item. So these preservatives simply inhibits the growth of microorganisms like bacteria and fungi. It at the same time, it is increasing the shelf life of your product. Sometimes it is responsible for giving a typical type of appearance or a specific type of appearance to your food. And it also preserves the natural food characteristic like odor, taste, food. And this can be preserved for longer period. So now it is important to know the classification of natural preservatives. So plants with natural antimicrobial activities, sometimes like rosemary or organo extracts are there, which people are using for different purposes or for preservation purposes. Then antimicrobial from microorganisms, as all you you know, we are deliberately using a number of different type of starter bacteria for achieving a certain type of characteristic in different kind of fermented dairy product. And a number of different type of antibiotics are also released by these microorganisms which have some type of antibacterial effect. Now, antimicrobials from animals, a number of animals are there which are also responsible for giving or for providing a different type of antimicrobial substance. So, from where we are getting these natural antimicrobials? Mainly we are getting it from plant, animal sources, microorganisms, algae. So these are the sources for different kind of natural antimicrobial substance which you can use as a preservative in different kind of food items. It also acts as viable and safer alternative to synthetic compound, because when you are selecting a particular type of synthetic compound, you may have to face some kind of abnormal situation. Sometimes there is some kind of side effect, and ultimately it will affect the human system. So automatically people have started thinking about these natural antimicrobial substances for preservation purposes. It also ensures food safety without impairing organoleptic or nutritional properties of food products. So we have already discussed about all those methods where we can preserve the natural things present in that particular food item. So if you are using these natural antimicrobials, automatically it will not affect the organoleptic and nutritional properties of your final product. And how it is acting on different food items? So it creates rupture of microbial cell membrane. So I have repeatedly told you people that how a chemical or how a process is affecting the cell membrane or different components present in cell membrane, and thereafter it will go inside and ultimately responsible for creating abnormal condition with different mechanism going inside, and it also prevents decay of proton motive forces, interferes with biomolecules activity inside the bacterial cell wall, and ultimately it will create or restrict or show some bactericidal effect and thus prolonging the shelf life of your product. The effect of natural antimicrobials on microorganism structure proved crucial for creating preservation effect of food item. So all these things are very important when you are going to study about the natural antimicrobial substance. So here in this figure, you can see the name of different natural antimicrobials and how it is affecting different type of microbial agents which are responsible for microbial spoilages, toxicity, and at the same time, it is responsible for affecting the organoleptic quality of your final product. So these are phenolics, then terpenes, isothiocyanates, alkaloids, microbial peptides are there, cytosan, lysozyme, fatty acid and glyceride, nicene, natamycin, pediocene, then lactic acid, algae extract, edible mushroom extracts. So these are the natural antimicrobial substances which are very frequently used for preservation purposes or for achieving certain type of characteristic in your product. And these are the different microorganisms: Staphylococcus aureus, Escherichia coli, Escherichia monocytogenes, Enterococcus faecalis, Shigella dysentrii, Clostridium terebutyricum, then Candida albicans, and Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Campylobacter azuzini, jejuni. So you people have to remember the name of these microbial agents as well as the natural antimicrobials which are produced or extracted from any system for preservation purposes. So in this table also some of the natural antimicrobial substance from plant sources, then animal sources, from algae and mushroom sources, and from bacteria and viruses sources are given, and it is directly used in different kind of food item. And whole world has started moving in this direction, that how you can and how one can utilize these items for improving the food quality of our food product or whatever product you are manufacturing. So sometimes people are using these extract from plant sources in packaging for treating packaging material, edible films and coatings for packaging. People have started using so many extract of these food items or whatever natural antimicrobial substance are produced. So just by getting complete idea about these natural antimicrobial substance, you can start using it in effective manner and for achieving your goal. So whatever natural antimicrobials are there, they are simply interact with the food components, and what is happening after that? They modify the foods organoleptic characteristic. Sometimes it is responsible for adding some kind of flavor, texture, or color to your product. In addition to its antimicrobial activity. So, first of all, some kind of micro encapsulation process is there, or micro capsules are formed. And after that, what is happening because of their activity, antimicrobial activity, and its stability in the product, and the controlled release of the main active ingredient present in that will create a condition which will restrict the activity of different kind of microbe. So a novel trend is arising, especially in health conscious consumer, and they have started expecting that natural antimicrobial act only against foodborne pathogens leaving the consumers. Natural microbiome which is present in their colon or internal system. So the negative effect of some synthetic preservative on the natural microbiome which are present in the consumer, that will not affect when you are using these kind of natural antimicrobial substance. So this is very important point, and you people, you have already idea about your colon, large intestine, how it is known as powerhouse of your body. And if you are using these natural antimicrobial substance, it will not affect the natural balance of microbiota inside your system. So that is very important. Now, in this table, I have tried to give you the name of different antimicrobial compound. I have also given sources, advantages and disadvantages of those compounds. So simply you have to remember the name of all these compounds which are responsible for creating some kind of antimicrobial effect, that is cytosine, ovotransferrin, lactoferrin, lysozyme, allicin, nisin, and natamycin. So you have to remember, and what are the sources of these antimicrobial compounds, and what are the advantages, how it is affecting, and which type of bacteria, mold, or yeast will be affected by these antimicrobial, natural antimicrobial compounds. So these are the different sources. These are the plant derived compounds, essential oils, plant extracts. Then if you talk about enzymes, lysozyme, lactoporosidase system, you have already idea about the lactoporosidase system, how it is affecting the growth and activity of natural or whatever contaminating microorganisms present in your raw milk, how you can prolong the shelf life of your raw milk. So just by activating or by using equimolar concentration of lactoperoxidase, thiocyanate, so by using that, you can improve the shelf life of your milk, even if you are keeping it at room temperature for 5-6 hours. So the other type of proteins which are generally found in different items like animal sources, lactoferrin, ovotransferrin, then some polysaccharides are also there which have some kind of antimicrobial activity, cytosine. Then microbial products, whatever microorganism or desirable group of starter bacteria you are using for achieving certain type of fermentation, all those microorganisms are also producing some amount of antibacterial substance. You have already idea about nisin, pediocin, diplococcine, and lactosine, lactosidine. So these are the different bacteriocines produced by different type of starter bacteria which you are using deliberately for achieving certain type of characteristic and certain type of textural changes in your final product. Now the antagonistic microorganisms, these are yeast, lactic acid bacteria, you know, or during studying that particular starter bacterial starter culture course, you must have got idea that whenever you are using some kind of lactic acid bacteria or yeast for achieving certain type of characteristic, it will also create a negative environment for some kind of pathogenic microorganism or whatever condition they are creating that will not support the growth of different type of spoilage organism, as well as some kind of pathogenic microorganism will also be affected by those microbes or whatever antibiotic released by those starter bacteria. So this is, in this case, I have tried to give you the list of biopolymer and essential oils for antimicrobial packaging. So these are the, simply you have to go through this slide and have some idea about the different type of essential oils which people are using for antimicrobial packaging, because nowadays it is getting a good popularity in different food industries. So you must have idea about this thing, that how you can create a protective layer and how can you can use it in a better way. And ultimately, for improving shelf life of your food item, how you can utilize these antimicrobial oils for treating your packaging material. Now, this one vinegar, which was not discussed earlier, so I just want to include this in today's lecture. So as per the PFA, Prevention of Food Adulteration Act, vinegar should contain a minimum of 3.75% acetic acid. Please mute your mobile, I am repeatedly telling you people. Vinegar that is manufactured by fermentation of fruit juices, potato and molasses by acetic acid bacteria and dilution of synthetic acid to a level of 3.75%. So, and how it is creating any sort of antimicrobial activity? So it simply lowers the pH of your food item, and it has been observed then when the food pH is below 3.5, it is 10 to 100 times more powerful than the other acid people are generally using for preservation purposes. So you can well imagine the condition of vinegar. It is highly effective at lower pH. And it also penetrates bacterial cell wall and denatures the cell plasma proteins. It also reduces the heat sensitive bacteria, and it is its action deteriorated when you are keeping or your food item pH is more than 5. So it is also very important, and people are using in preparation of different kind of pickles and different type of vegetables and fruit preservation purposes. Now the table sugar and salt, we have studied a lot about this in dairy industry. What, where we are using this sugar? We are using it in preparation or manufacturing of sweetened condensed milk, and you know the effect of that particular component which you are additionally using for giving a typical type of taste, as well as for making it more safer for human consumption, and you can keep that sweetened condensed milk for a longer period. And what kind of action is there of sugar? And it is well known fact that when the concentration of sugar is 60, more than 60% in your finished product, it simply assures a good preservative effect on food. So what is happening? It is generally people are using it for making jellies and cured hams, and the cell growth of the microorganism is inhibited, or the organism itself may be completely destroyed when the total concentration of sugar will be increased. And salt, something about salt. Same as sugar, salt also causes dehydration by drying out the and tying up water from the tissues of the food. And what is happening in that? It is responsible for ionization, yielding the chlorine ion, which is harmful to microorganisms and interferes with the action of proteolytic enzyme. So this is the thing for which affect the microbial growth in a particular product. So if you are adding more salt, then it shows a greater protection effect in your food item. So automatically you have to keep this thing in your mind. And now, what are the mechanism of action? So mechanism of, if you talk about the mechanism of action, you must have heard about the osmosis process, or what is happening in that. Because of osmosis, water from fruits leaves in a sugar solution and sugar enters into the fruit. And automatically the concentration of sugar inside the system will increase and ultimately responsible for creating preservative effect. So sugar reduces the solubility of oxygen in water, and it also decreases the water activity of food and inhibits the growth of microbes. So in dairy industry, where we are using sugar at very high level, especially in our sweetened condensed milk, the water activity is in the range of 0.85 to 0.86. And at that temperature, at that water activity level, no pathogenic microorganism will survive. Even the maximum limit of survival for Staphylococcus aureus is 0.86 in aerobic condition. So you can well imagine the condition, just by adding sugar or salt, you can prevent. In butter manufacturing, we are using some amount of salt. It will give some type of flavor to your product, and at the same time, it is dissolved in aqueous phase of butter, and that concentration level, which is achieved after adding that sugar, is sufficient to inhibit all sort of microorganisms generally present in your aqueous phase of butter. Now, the most important thing is to get idea about the lactoferrin, which is also known as activated lactoferrin, and it is an antimicrobial protein present in milk, and it shows antibacterial, antifungal, antiviral activity. So you can see the multidirectional effect of this particular lactoferrin, and it is generally found in or present in saliva, tears, and some other body fluid. And how it is affecting microbial cell is it simply binds the microbial cell surfaces and has a high affinity for outer membrane proteins of gram-negative bacteria. And it is also responsible for inhibiting the growth of toxin-producing microorganisms. And it also creates a very good condition in different type of food item where some amount of toxin substance are also liberated in the system by neutralizing those endotoxins. Now the next one is ozone. You must have heard about this ozone because it is recognized as safe, especially in bottled water. So this is a gaseous compound and it possesses antimicrobial activity. And just like chlorine, it is most powerful oxidant available for conventional water treatment and is highly reactive. And it is 1.5 times more potent than chlorine. So you can think about its effectiveness in controlling different type of microorganisms. So it is effective against gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, as well as viruses and protozoa. So proton treatment can be used in vegetables, fruits, beef extract, especially for controlling or destroying different type of pathogenic microorganisms like Escherichia coli and Salmonella typhimurium. The next one is hydrogen peroxide. People are very frequently using this particular chemical in our dairy industry. Sometimes people are adding it in raw milk for preservation purposes because a particular type of enzyme that is known as catalase, which is already present in the system, and ultimately it will degrade this hydrogen peroxide into, or it will convert this hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen molecule. So it is very frequently used, and the second most important use of this particular compound for treating different kind of tetra packs. So whenever you are using some ultra high temperature treatment during processing, ultimately we have to pack that milk, or we have to use a strict packages which is already treated by UV light as well as this particular hydrogen peroxide. So it is used as a sterilant for food contact surfaces of olefin polymers and polyethylene in aseptic packaging system. So what is happening? the vapor of this hydrogen peroxide have some type of microbiocidal properties, and because of their antimicrobial effect, it causes or it attributes to a strong oxidizing effect on the bacterial cell and to the destruction of basic molecular structure of cellular protein. So how it is affecting a particular microorganism? So this is the region, because of its strong character, a strong oxidizing effect on bacterial cell. So it is generally used for the treatment of vegetable, fruit and fruit juices in form of vapor. So if you talk about, and the next one is antimicrobial peptides. As all you you know that we are using several type of starter bacteria during fermentation process, and during that process a number of different type of peptides are formed. In some cases those peptides are responsible, or those peptides acts against different type of contaminating microorganisms, and at the same time in some cases it is responsible for creating bacteriostatic effect, and in some cases it is responsible for bactericidal effect on different type of microorganisms. So these antimicrobial peptides are isolated from other natural sources also, such as plants, insects, amphibians and marine organisms, and these are widely distributed in nature. So our main aim is to study this particular course or this particular topic, that how we can extract different antimicrobial substance from different sources. Now the next one is spices and essential oil. You have already idea about the allicin of garlic. Then you have idea about the eugenol in cloves, cinnamon, and cloves oils are also very effective against Aspergillus parasiticus, and especially which this organism is responsible for aflatoxin production. So if these things are present, and if you people are adding these compounds in a typical product or in a specific type of product, automatically just by restricting the growth and activity of Aspergillus, you are at the same time you are also restricting the aflatoxin production. So a number of different type of food items, cumin, caraway and coriander, have inhibitory effect on different type of microorganisms. And now it is also very important to know that how it works and how it is affecting the different microbial microbes present in your food item. So gram positive peptidoglycan cell wall allows hydrophobic molecules to penetrate and reach the internal environment. So in case of gram-positive bacteria, it is responsible for invading the cell wall, and at the same time in gram-positive bacteria, the lipopolysaccharide is the part where it is affecting the system. And what is happening after, because of the hydrophobicity of these different type of essential oils, which you can extract from different sources, how it is affecting the bacteria? It simply degrades the cell wall and cytoplasmic membrane, and the cell cytoplasm coagulation and diffusion is responsible for alteration of permeability of cell wall, and at the same time it will affect the function of whole bacterial cell and ultimately create bactericidal effect. Now these are the different spices and herbs, and these are the inhibitory effect given in this table. And turmeric, interturmeric, curcumin, and in paper, piperine, and in clove, eugenol can be extracted, and further it can be utilized in different kind of food item, not for giving preservation effect, but it also adds some type of nutritive value and some type of taste to your final product. And finally, the mechanism of action I have given here and I have noted down here. It simply damages the membrane integrity of microorganisms and causes leakage of ions, adenosine triphosphate, production, nucleic acid and amino acid from microorganisms. And it also affects pH of the microorganism when used at high concentration. So you can see if you are adding this, it can work even at higher pH level, just by affecting the ATP production inside the cell, nucleic acid and amino acid present inside a particular type of microorganism. So this is all about herbal species. Next one is antioxidant. What is happening in this? Generally, it is preventing rancidity in foods and food containing fat. And generally, butylated hydroxy anisole and butylated hydroxy toluene, these are the two compounds which people are using very effectively in different type of food item. And in addition to this, propyl gallate and tocopherols, vitamin E, ascorbic acid, vitamin C and lecithins are also used for different purposes, and these can be extracted from these food items. So what is happening in this and how it is? It is you can synthetically get this antioxidant, or sometimes you have to get it from natural sources. But it has been observed that natural sources are more effective, but the one limitation is there, that is expensive, and extraction is very costly. So what is happening in case of antioxidant? So just by, you must have heard about the free radical reaction in different food items. So just by donating hydrogen ion, it restricts the whole free radical reaction chain and ultimately create a negative environment for different type of microorganisms, which can utilize the different substance present in your food item. So it simply slows down the oxidation rates of food by a combination of scavenging free radicals, chelating pro-oxidative metals and quenching singlet oxygen and photosynthesizers and inactivating lipooxygenase. So just by doing and just by adding these antioxidant, you can restrict the free radical reaction and automatically you can prolong the shelf life of your food item. So it is very effectively in different type of foods. Now, antibiotic substance. As all of you know, that a number of different type of fungi like penicillium and bacteria that, like streptomycin and actinomycetes, they are responsible for creating or producing different kind of antibiotic substance, which can be used for different purposes. People, if you are suffering from some kind of problem or diseases or some kind of abnormal situation is there, automatically you will start taking different kind of antibiotic items. But nowadays, people have started using these antibiotic in food item for preservation purposes, and it was started in 1950 with the use of tetracycline in poultry. So what are the considering point? Antibiotic agents should kill and not inhibit the flora, should ideally decompose the harmless product, it is destroyed on cooking, should not be inactivated by food component present in the system or whatever metabolite presents or produced by different microbe that cannot be that cannot inhibit or inactivate these antibiotic substance, and it should not readily stimulate development of resistant strain, should not be used in food if therapeutically or as animal feed additives you are using. And where you can use and what type of different type of antibiotics can be used in food items. So tetracycline, ceftiline, tylosin, nisin and natamycin, people are using for different purposes. And our main aim is to control the bacterial growth or whatever contaminating microorganisms may present or enter in the, into the system that will be affected by using these natural preservatives. So this is all about preservation courses. So in the next class, we will start some another topic or some other things. So this is all about the different type of preservation method, why we are using, how, what are the different food items where you can use different type of preservatives of compounds and how it is affecting the bacterial cell, or how it is affecting or restricting the growth and activity, and ultimately what kind of condition it will create in the final product, and how long you can store those products. You people have studied in this particular topic. Thank you. Thanks a lot.